Hello kids, welcome back again with a new video. In this video, we are going to start a new chapter, chapter 3, playing with numbers. Now, let us understand the relation of factors and multiples, that how these factors and multiples are connected with each other. Let us understand this relation by an example. Now, we will learn how to find all the factors of a given number. So here, let's learn by few examples. Now, first we will find the factors of 24. Now, the easiest way to understand or to find the factors of a given number, we will always find a number in a form of product of two numbers. For example, 24. Now, 24 is a product of 1 and 24. So, 1 24s are. It will give me 24. Let's find few more set of the numbers which gives 24 as a product. So, second is 2 12s are 24. 3 8s are 24. 4 6s are 24. Now, to know whether all the factors of a given number has covered or not. So, always remember, go in a sequence. So, we'll always start with 1 because 1 is a factor of all the numbers. So, 1, 24s are 24. Then we'll move to the number 2. So, we'll find the pair of 2, that 2 how many are 24, so 2 12s are 24. Then we'll move to the number 3. So, 3 is multiplied by 8 and we'll get the answer 24. After 3, we'll go to the 4. So, 4 6s are 24. Now, after 4, the number 5 comes. But 5 is not an exact divisor of 24. So, we'll move to the 6. Now, if you observe, the 6 is already covered in the given numbers. So, if 6 is covered, bigger than 6 also, all the numbers are covered. It means we have covered all the factors of 24. Let's learn about one more number, that is 30. So, let's find out all the factors of 30 keeping few points in mind. So, here also we'll be finding the product of two numbers. So, here we'll start with 1. So, 1 we'll find the pair of 1, that is 30. So, 1 30s are 30. Another number after 1 will go to 2. So, 2 15s are 30. Then we'll go to 3. So, 3 10s are 30. Then we'll think of 4, but 4 is not an divisor, not an exact divisor of 30. So, we'll go to 5. So, 5, 6 are 30. After 5, it comes 6, which is already covered over here. Also, the numbers which are bigger than 6 are also covered. Means, all the factors of 30 is covered. So, here you can say the factors of 30 are 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 10, 15 and 30. So again, we can derive or we can understand that factors are the numbers which are exact divisor of the given number. Now let us learn about multiples. What is multiple? So here again we'll understand by an example. So let's take a number 7. Now the product of 7, that is 7 ones are 7, then next 7 twos are 14, then 7 threes are 21. Now the multiple word itself says that there are multiple numbers. Multiple numbers means there is no end of the number. So here, if you say which is the greatest multiple of 7, so here finding the greatest multiple of any number is not possible because multiples are infinite. Now let us understand the same thing with one more example. Let's take 2. We'll start with ones are. So the 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4, 2 threes are 6, and so on. Here you can observe one more thing is that multiples of 2 are all even numbers. So here we can derive that multiples are infinite, whereas the factors are finite. So multiples of 2, as we have understood that multiples of 2 are even numbers. So if multiples of 2 are even numbers, so rest of the numbers, for example 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, all are not multiples of 2. So if multiples of 2 are even numbers, then the numbers which are not multiples of 2 are odd numbers. So here we can understand the concept of even numbers and odd numbers also. Now let us understand about the relation of factors and multiples. To learn and to understand more about the relation of factors and multiple, we will observe one example. So here we'll take a number 12 and we'll be finding all the factors of 12. And then after finding the factors of 12, we will understand that how the factors and multiples are related with each other. So here again, as I have said, we'll go in a sequence. We'll start with 1, that 1 12s are 12. Then after 1, we'll take number 2, then 2 6 are 12, then 3, 3 4s are 12. Now after 3, 4, which has already come, it means we have covered all the factors of 12. Now, if you observe these factors, now one or another way we can say that 12 is multiple of all its factors. Means 12 is a multiple of 1, 12 is a multiple of 2, 12 is a multiple of 3, 12 is a multiple of 4, 12 is a multiple of 6, and 12 is also a multiple of 12. Because this all numbers means this all the factors are an exact divisor of 12. It means this all the numbers can divide 12, leaving no remainder. So we can say that a number is a multiple of each of its factors. Now let us learn about few facts about factors and multiples. First fact, that 1 is a factor of all the numbers, because 1 is an exact divisor of all the numbers. So you can call 1 as a factor of all the numbers. Second, every number is a factor of itself. It means each and every number can divide itself without leaving a remainder. It means if I consider 12, now 12 is a factor of itself. So 12 can divide itself, 12 divided by 12, which will not leave any remainder. So you can say that every number is a factor of itself. Third point is, every factor is less than or equal to the given number. It means the factors cannot be greater than the given number. For example, if I give you a number 28, so you will get the highest factor is as 28. You can get factors less than 28, but you can never get a factor more than 28. So this is just an example. You can understand it by taking any other number also. So here, if you observe the factors of any number, they are always less than the number or equal to the number. Now next, number of factors of a given number are finite. Finite means factors are limited in a number. It is always fixed. You cannot decrease it. You cannot increase it. You can count number of factors of any given number so that you can say that they are finite, means they are limited. But if you see the multiples are infinite. That we'll learn afterwards. So now, the next point is, every multiple of a number is greater than or equal to the number. Now if you observe the multiples of any number, the smallest multiple is the number itself, so that you can say that every multiple is either equal to the number or greater to that number. But you will never get a greatest or the highest multiple of any number, because multiples are infinite. So as I've said, the multiples of a given number is infinite, means there is no end, or you can say there are unlimited multiples of any number. Now, every number is a multiple of itself. As we have discussed that the smallest multiple, the first multiple, is always a number itself. So you can say that every number is a multiple of itself. Now, we will learn about a perfect number. Now, this is something new for you. What is a perfect number? So here we will understand about perfect number by few examples. Before we see the example, let us know the definition of perfect number. So, a number for which sum of all its factors is equals to twice the number is called a perfect number. So it means here you are finding factors, all the factors of any number, then you have to do the addition, or you have to find out the sum. Now sum should be double of the given number, then only you can call the number as a perfect number. Let us learn more about perfect number by an example. The first example, let us take factors of 6. Now the factors of 6 are 1, 2, 3 and 6. Now let us find out the sum of all the factors. So that is 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 6. Now the sum of all the factors is 12, which is twice of the number 6. So here 12 is a twice of 6, means double of 6. So 6 is a perfect number. Let us understand the same thing with one more example. So let's see one more example. Here we'll be finding out the factors of 28. So factors of 28 are 1, 2, 4, 7, 14 and 28. So now after finding all the factors, our next step is to get the sum of all the factors, means we have to add all the factors. So the factors addition, so 1 plus 2 plus 4 plus 7 plus 14 plus 28 and the sum is 56. Now 56 is a twice of 28. So here 28 is also a perfect number. So here is the calculation. You can try with your any number, but it is yes necessary to find all the factors to all the factors of the number, and then you can also find out whether your number is a perfect number or not. So the rest of the things will continue in our next video. So take care, stay safe. We'll meet soon with a new concept and with the new things.